the message is going to be. The message is going to be four. I guess they're telling me to keep the mic a little bit away. So anyway, 844prayerswithaz.com. And right now, I would like to take the offering. So Damon, if you want to help with that, we'll pray over it. And I got to remember to keep this mic away from my mouth, right, Julie?
No, stop walking, dude.
All right, well, that's okay. I'm just going to put this on. So we're going to do the offering and play some music. So. Lord, we ask that you bless this offering, that the seeds that are sown will go further than they have ever gone before, that it will increase your kingdoms. We know that everything comes from you, so we give to you, and we know that your word says that that is the only area that we can test you is when we tithe. For your word says that when we give, you will open up the heavens and pour down blessing upon us, and that we can test you in that way and see that you will do what you said, because you are a promise-keeping God. And we ask that you just bless these precious gifts and just increase the people that give. We thank you for this time in Jesus' name. That's good. Amen.
Measure of grace, the people that are trying to hold this up that say she can't have her child. God, we come against that in Jesus' name, Father. We break that. She is a child. She is a woman, a strong woman of God. And we ask that you just grant her request. Bring Elijah back. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Amen.
Next. Let's keep going.
Thank him.
I love you.
Thank you.
Jesse?
Yes.
Thank you, Father. For Jesse, thank you for God. Holy Spirit, just come right now and start to minister to his body. We ask God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Yes, Father. Oh, strengthen his heart, Father. Strengthen his heart. God, we're going to ask right now, Father, we're going to ask from here, from the ground up, from your earthen vessel, Father, that you will just start to fill and start to touch him and fill up with the Holy Spirit. We ask that it rises up right now, rises up in his legs and starts to strengthen, Father, strengthen these knees, start to strengthen and replace and rebuild cartilage, Father, anything that has been damaged or broken down, Father, spongy bones, Father, we ask that you start to fill them in with calcium, your Holy Spirit, fill them up, Father, we just ask that you start to fill his body up, strengthen his stride, strengthen him out, Father, strengthen him up, thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, praise you, Jesus, thank you, Father, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Why do we worry, Father? This one right here, this is what this day is for, Father. You've been preparing our hearts for this. You've been preparing your word in my heart that's going to be sown into his, Father. So we come to you right now, Father, with healing hands, Lord, and that you save his life, Father, and that you will use him as a testimony. From the time that I touch his forehead forth, Father, he will be healed. And we will ask for complete restoration, and that whatever's in his body, anything that's beating him down, that the doctors say that he cannot and he will not, and he only has this long to live, Father, he lives with you. He is victorious in Christ, and we ask that you anoint him right now, Father, and just heal him in Jesus' name, Father. Complete healing, save his life, Father. Come upon him and start to fill him up with your Holy Spirit right now, Father, ministering to the areas that are broken, ministering to the areas that are sick. No more sickness, no more evil will befall this child of God that will come across this tent. You have made him a strong man of God, Father. He will be a testimony to you. We ask that you, Holy Spirit, also look in him and ask him to be a man of God. Oh, thank you, Father. Lord, touch his heart, heal his heart, Father. Oh, Lord, speak to us, help us. Help us, Father, more, Father. Oh, thank you, minister to you. On earth, this time, speaking, testimonies, walking, talking about how you saved him and let him live longer to an old man, touching lives along the way. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I know there's some of you out there, I know this is odd that we're praying across the internet and the globe, but there is a hurting heart. There is someone that is crushed right now in spirit that feels like they can't carry on, and they're lost. Their hope is gone, and they feel like they can't move another day or move or breathe another breath. I ask, Father, that you come right now and that you give them life. In abundance, Father, and fill them up with hope and joy. That your Spirit will start to surround them right now. And they will just be touched, Father, to be able to stand up,
straight and strong and walk. Thank you, Father. And we just pray for everybody that's online or watching later, Father, that your Holy Spirit can touch them even through this right now. God, prayers have no boundaries. They have nothing. They can be sent through the air, across the air, so your Holy Spirit angels will minister to any situation. So we speak to all of them, and we ask that you fill everybody up, prepare their hearts for this message, the testimony that Rick has and Julie has. Be with us, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you so much. Thank you, Father. Bless you, Lord. So who needs more? Christy? Breathing? Troubles? Doing better? We prayed the other day, right? So we're good, yes. So we're gonna ask that to be finished off in Jesus' name, right? And then we know all that the Lord's going to speak to our brothers. Father, we come to you, we bring Christy to your throne, Father, in intercession and agreement together as a church body, Father, that her nephew, Father, Cooper, that you will just, he's in heaven right now, Father, you already start ministering to his little body that was just born a few days ago, Father. You can restore, Father, so breathe life. I feel a pumping sensation, Father, just building into him more life, more air, pumping up his lungs and his body so he can breathe freely right now. Freely breathing, Father. Breathless of air, and as he breathes out, he will breathe your spirit in that will minister to the broken parts and the parts that were not built correctly, Father. There are your parts, and you will restore them, Father. We ask that you just heal him. And then for Christy, Father, more. Oh, heavy heart, Father. We already feel that, Father. We feel that. We feel some guilt here going on here that maybe if I could have, if I would have been there, if I would have done a little bit more for Mario, that he might still be here, Father. But it was your divine appointment that was there, Father. It was not chosen by him. It was chosen by you, Father. He is rejoicing with you in heaven, Father. The angels, when he came up, said his name and was cried. And we just ask that you restore her heart from that, Father, and that you remove any guilt from her body and just fill her up with hope and have her remember to keep her eyes focused on Jesus and the fact that any loved ones that have passed from this earthly realm into the heavenlies are in heaven. So we should rejoice and be glad in that, Father. So we sow that into her right now, Father. We ask that you strengthen her, give her wisdom and courage to be a good mother to her children, that they will listen to her and she will learn to speak with strength and strictness and a godly voice to them. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Lord. Is there anybody else? All right, ready? We're good? More prayers? Anybody out there? Internet, God, anybody
Woo,
else?
Go God!
Huh?
Woo, go God!
Woo, go God! All right. Thank you guys so much. Thank you so much.
All right, we're going to try to get this moving. Today we have a couple special treats for everybody. It's kind of we do things different here. We kind of free-for-all. We go where the Spirit lets us go. It's not very regimented. We have a set, kind of a schedule. But today we're going to hear a couple of testimonies from Pastor Rick, one of our elders here at the church is going to share a bit today. You just told me, right? So, and then after that, Julie, who's just came to the church. We prayed for her to get out of jail so that she could be there for her son, who we just prayed for, to get him back. And she actually got released from jail 22 days early. And she's got a story of what the Lord's been doing in her life and has done. But first, let's have Rick come up. Give Rick a good hand of applause. A thunderous hand clap, as Pastor Anthony might say. All right, here you go, sir. You can come up here or stay down there. It's up to you. Use the mic because I guess people have a hard time hearing.
All right. Do they? You really have a hard time hearing.
All right.
All right. I just figured I'd let everyone, a bunch of the people here that have been here with us for a while, already know my story. I just kind of figured it was a good story that I should share with everyone else. Basically, it's a modern-day story of the prodigal son. that many years ago, when I was more of a heathen than I am now, I was very heavy into drugs, very heavy into liquor. I was leading quite a selfish lifestyle. I did what I wanted, when I wanted, and how I wanted. It didn't matter to me. As long as my flesh was happy, I was happy.
Yep.
So I thought. That trail led me in for a while, but at a point, something spoke to me that I was basically going nowhere. So I figured, well, let's try giving the military a try. So I went and I joined the military. I was in the Army. And the one place in my life where I got to say the Lord gave me one good swift kick up in the head was when I was on maneuvers on a port called Cornsville. And it had been raining, and the ground was very muddy. And if anyone knows anything about sinkholes, they're not a pleasant thing, especially when you encounter them. Not many people actually get out of sinkholes when they encounter them. Well, I was supposed to be the pace man when in placing a minefield when the ground let out from under me, and I sunk up to my armpits. I was only fortunate that I had stuck my arms out with my weapon so that basically it gave me a little more foothold on the earth. And, well, the people I was working with in the vehicle just happened to drive off. They didn't even pay attention. And I was stuck in that hole, and I figured, okay, let's give it a try. I tried pulling myself out, and all I ended up doing was pulling more mud down on top of me. I was basically up to my chin when I finally decided, I've done everything I can do, let's give the Lord a try. And all my prayer was, please don't let my mother get a letter saying her son drowned in the mud. Next thing I know, before I was even finished, the Lord popped me out of that sucker like a zit, and I landed about 15, 20 feet away from me. Face down, blew up, but I landed. I gotta say, that was one good swift kick up in the head. It got my attention. I wasn't necessarily perfect after that. I'm still not perfect. But it definitely got me on the right path. And it's a path I haven't turned from, and I don't plan to. And it's taught me many, many things. Two of the most important things that it taught me was, we live in this earth. We live on this earth. It's very easy to get sucked up into this earth, just like a sinkhole. Mm-hmm. Leads to nowhere. Also, if you try putting your faith into another person, no matter their intentions, how good they may be, we are flawed. We will let you down. We will leave you behind. But the Lord is always there.
That's right. Amen.
And
that's it, sir.
Oh, there you go.
Good job, Brother Rick. All right. That's awesome. Short and sweet. All right. Well, the next... anybody else have any testimonies before we get Julie up? Anything that happened this week in the congregation that you guys want to share on? I'll pass the mic to you. And like it says in God's Word in Revelation 12:11, it says they defeated him, Satan, by the blood of the Lamb and the testimony of the saints. So your guys' testimony actually helps finish the plan for God because he already gave the blood, and we just give our testimonies and we share with people what he's doing, which increases their hope. So does anybody have anything they want to share first before Julie comes up? You already shared? You got one more?
Oh, heck yeah.
All right. Here we go.
Sure. This one was my employer whose daughter was pregnant. And she had been pregnant many other times, but unfortunate circumstances, she had quite a few miscarriages. We prayed for her. And thank the Lord that he listened, and her child was born, 10 fingers, 10 toes, everything seems to be responsive and outstanding, and she's still going strong.
Thank you, Jesus. All right. Come on, anybody else? Someone else got the, I mean, I know there's stuff going on every day. Anything? No? Once, going once, going twice, three times, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. We're cool. All right. Let's give a thunderous hand clap for us, Julie.
And God, he turned off that guy's phone number. And I tried to call him and call him and call him, and I was like, okay, God, no, I know. And he made it point blank, this is not what's happening to my child. So I told Lori, I have nowhere to go. I have nothing. My car's been stolen. I'm starting off fresh. Pastor Scott gets on the phone and gives me the most biggest blessing and lets me come home to his house. Not only do I have a friend that I trust completely, I have his mom, who is absolutely adorable, and I feel like she cheers for me, and it's a blessing now. I've never had that. It's a humbling experience. I just got a job at the 99-cent store. I've only been out. I've only been out for a week and a half or something like that. And I have a probation officer that's known me since I was 18 years old. He can pull my covers and tell me, Julie, this is what you're doing, and I know you're doing it. Or if I get defensive, what's going on with you? But he roots for me. I have law officials that I've known since I was 16 years old getting smoking tickets, that he tells me that they're rooting for me, that they see me. I have 5 years sober. I have a wonderful friend here right now that I love to pieces that just broke me down crying when I saw him. And I don't want to be that girl anymore. I want to be able to reach out to my friends. I want to be able to be a somewhat daughter to Evelyn. I want to be a child of God. I want to reach out to people. And God's just been blessing me. I have four children. 3 daughters were taken away from me by social services. My 15-year-old daughter's back in my life. I haven't seen her in 9 years. And she acts like I was never gone. She's an amazing little girl. She goes to church. She's been raised in an awesome way. And I'm truly blessed for that. I have a beautiful 4-year-old son that I let my addiction take over. And he was taken away from me. And I just went to the jails and I to minister to one of my friends who accidentally killed somebody. And when I was there, there was a man with a cross shirt on. And he was there. He didn't know why he pulled into the jail. He just felt he had to go there. And he prayed for me about my son. He showed me that what God's word says, I can rely on. Like, I needed to hear that. I mean, I read it, yeah, but when I hear somebody say, I don't know why I pulled in here, yeah, I have a kid that's here, but I didn't want to ever see him, and be like, but come here and tell me what you want. What do you want me to pray for? And I'm like, okay, my baby. This is my child that's a mom with a boy. It's a different bond than a mom with a girl, and my son is just amazing. And we prayed. And then right after, I had my friend or my ex-husband, my son's father, tell me, social services don't want to talk to you anymore. That you don't have a chance getting that baby. But I know that the devil's attacking.
Right. Yeah.
I know I'm his mom. I know I'm the best mom he could possibly ever have. His name is Elijah, and I named him that because I found God. I had a strong relationship with God before that. Before he was born, I had 5 years sober. I was sober before he was even conceived, and that's amazing for me to be able to have that sobriety. And when I had a turn.